The National Environment Management Authority has now denied reports linking them to the recent demolitions of buildings on riparian land. According to NEMA, the demolition of Java House Kyle Leshwa, South End Mall among other structures was also not authorized by the Water Resources Authority as earlier indicated. They were speaking on Thursday when they appeared before the Parliamentary Committee on Environment and Natural Resources. NEMA officials claimed that the demolitions were sanctioned under the Nairobi Regeneration Project. The revelations sparked outrage, with the House committee demanding that those who authorized construction of buildings on riparian land be investigated and prosecuted. The Directorate of Criminal Investigations DCI and the DPP must investigate and prosecuted officials found culpable, Mbeuki said. Tharakanithi MP Kek Mbeuki, who is also the committee chairman, demanded that state agencies take responsibility for issuing licenses against the law. This comes after the management of UKI Centre produced letters from NEMA and WRA approving canalisation of River Kabraj. The Merriam-Webster dictionary defines canalisation as creation of a system of water channels. In this case, UKI Centre canalised the river before construction of buildings adjacent to it. Buildings near River Kabraj such as Nakumat UKI had been reportedly earmarked for demolition, with the owners saying that tenants had started moving out in fear of losing their businesses. If you go to UKI Centre, Nakumat UKI is closed. Tenants are leaving. I was going to collapse here. Let the media know we are being taken round and round, one of the owners told the house team.